in the book of John, yun sinabi ni Pastor Rodio, on chapter 13, verse 34, a new command I gave you. Who's talking here? The Lord Jesus Christ. He said, a new command I gave you. Love one another as I have loved you. Does the Lord Jesus Christ love you? Does the Lord Jesus Christ love you, bro? How about you, brother? Pastor Rodioan. Amen. So, the Lord Jesus Christ said, asa na? Ayun. Love one another as I have loved you. Of course, another one is that has a different meaning. One another, no? So, love one another as I have loved you. So, let us love one another as the Lord Jesus Christ has loved us. Diba? Tingnan nyo yung mga katabi nyo. Huh? Do you love him or her as the Lord Jesus Christ loved you? Amen. So, yun ang sabi ng Panginoong Jesus, love one another as I have loved you. So, you must love one another. Anong sabi niya? What did he say? In verse 35. By this, everyone, sino daw? Everyone. Tayo lang ba? Only us? Everyone. Everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. So, yun pala. No? So, if we love one another, everyone will know that we are his disciples. Again, we go back in Matthew 28, verse 19, right? The Great Commission, make disciples of every nation, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. No? So, ang that the anong tawag ba dito? Yung tangible, hindi tangible, yung evidence. The evidence of being a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ if we are loving one another. So if we are not loving one another, then no matter ganong kaalam natin sa Biblia, no matter ganong karami yung pagbibigay natin ng tithes, no matter ganong karami yung pagpapagal natin sa ministry, but if we don't love one another, yes, there's something wrong. We cannot be his disciples, no. Why? Because God is love.